joining us once again. And I've seen some of your colleagues on other networks just in so many words say just very pessimistic about the prospects for this because of, in their view, the speaker's not ready to give a win to President Trump. But then the other side would point out that Leader McConnell probably doesn't have the wherewithal to go through with what the president would want anyway. Is anything going to happen in your view?
Well, first, I'm still getting through the trauma. I grew up with that Marco Polo game, and the thing was very traumatic for me as a child.
The fact that
you guys opened with it took me a minute to compose myself. And on the stimulus thing, look, I think the fundamental challenge we face with it is the cost, you know, the dollar figure and how much it is. Clearly, there are Republicans in the Senate that will not vote for a deal that goes to $1.8 trillion. Look, I'm not happy about the cost associated with it, but I do think the cost of not doing something is potentially even higher, especially since some of that money that we're talking about in the 1.6, whatever number they arrive at, is repurposed money, like the PPP money that was unused. So it's not new spending. In the end, I think we run the risk here of structural damage to components of our economy if we don't do something. I also think we haven't seen the worst yet from some cities and counties. I'm not talking about cities and counties that ran up big debts on their, you know, pension plans prior to the pandemic, but some of the things going on, for example, with local option taxes, that's money that's bonded against for infrastructure spending. They're going to have to pull out of general revenue. They're going to have to pull funds out of general revenue next year to backfill that if those bed taxes go down and so forth. So we have some issues with some housing issues around the country as well. And look, the small business piece is really important. And it's something, you know, I have a meeting this morning with the chair in the House and the vice chair in the House, along with Senator Cardin, my counterpart. We're going to talk about this. So I have more optimism that we're going to have a deal on stimulus. I don't know if it'll be before the election, just simply because of the calendar and some of the time constraints we face. But whether it's right now or early November, I wish it had been yesterday. You know, I wish it had been 3 months ago. But we do need to do more.
Do you think if there weren't political considerations that $500 billion would have been palatable to Speaker Pelosi in terms of it? Obviously, it's not everything that she wants, but there are some really positive and helpful things in the $500 billion. And to have a choice of either taking it or leaving it, I mean, you could take it and then work on all the other things later. If you weren't using it as a cudgel or as leverage or as cynically as a something to for political reasons, what would preclude you from saying, okay, let's just do that and get this out and then we'll start arguing again?
Yeah, let me pull back the curtain on that. I mean, 3 months ago, their position was let's come up with something they know they'll never take, because nothing will happen, the economy will get bad, the president will get blamed for it, and Republicans will lose elections. That was the attitude that the Democratic leadership took. I think what happened in the interim is that rank-and-file members of the Democratic Party started pressuring the speaker because it's their districts and the economy and their homes that were being hurt. And so that's where she kind of came off of that position. I still think that she probably and they probably prefer a deal post-election. But even if it's pre-election, it'll be too late to really have an impact on the economy. So if we weren't in an election season, I still think there would have been obstacles, but it certainly would have been easier. And that's why I think a post-election situation. But even that's not a guarantee. I mean, depending on how the election turns out, some people may calculate that they could get a better deal in January. So we'll see. Look, I'm cautiously optimistic, but we've already seen this this thing take a lot of twists and turns. It's really unfortunate. Especially for small businesses that are getting crushed out there and the jobs that are going to be lost because of this.
Hey, Senator, let me just ask. Oh,
go ahead. No,
let me ask
I thought I heard you
about this.
Go ahead. Yeah.
Yeah. We've had a couple of Democratic senators who have been on this week who also sit on the Small Business Committee and who've been concerned about this. And I've been pretty pointed in asking them, if there wasn't a deal that could get done by Pelosi and Mnuchin, would they go ahead and vote to release some of the PPP existing funds just to make sure the small businesses are taken care of? Let me ask you the flip side of that. If something happens that there is a deal that's cut between Pelosi and Mnuchin and it's a much higher number than you feel comfortable with, would you go ahead and vote for that anyway just to get the funds out?
Yeah, look, I'm pretty open. In order to pass something here, and I think we have to remind people this all the time, the only way you pass a law here is you have to have it passed by a Democratic House, a Republican Senate where you still need Democratic votes, and signed by a Republican president. So no one's going to get everything they want here. And from my perspective, that means the the bill on this is probably going to be higher than I want it to be. And I'm very uncomfortable with that. That said, I think the price of not doing something is even higher. So as long as it's limited in some way, I mean, as long as it's not crazy, yes, I'm willing to be flexible about it because I think it's that important. I think the damage to our economy is much greater than the benefit of not doing anything would ever be in terms of the debt. So, as I've said before, I'm willing to vote for things I'm not in favor of in order to pass the things I think are essential and important for our country within reason.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.